Hi, I'm Sonia, and in this video, I thought I would talk about revision. So I have mentioned revision in past videos. I've mentioned it in some of the tarot readings I've done, and it wasn't something that I was comfortable talking about because I hadn't really played with it. So I got the concept of revision, right? So if your thoughts create what you're experiencing, you can choose to think anything you want about anything. So it makes sense that you could think something different about the past. But I didn't have anything that was coming to mind that was like, I need to revise that. So I didn't have a situation to try it on. And then one came up naturally. And I've been using revision, but not in a consistent manner. I'm just using it when the thought of that experience comes up. And I have been very much so shocked by the changes that I am seeing from changing my thoughts about something that happened in the past. So I wanted to make a video just talking about, my experience with revision. And just, I think just that, my experience with it. And so maybe it will help you understand what people are talking about when they're talking about revision. So, like I said, your thoughts create everything. The only thing that is under your control is the present moment. What you are thinking about in the present moment, you have full control over. Whether that is thinking about the future, making an assumption about what's happening in the present, or continuing to tell the same story about the past, or have the same thoughts about the past, or have the same reaction to things that happened in the past. So, I don't even remember what triggered this memory, but I had this memory. It was very vivid. It's been kind of coming into my life. Not like super often, but just it kept coming up. And I think I know why, or actually, I do know why. It's because I am doing this. I am being creative. I am in flow, listening to my intuition, doing something that I enjoy, making these videos for YouTube, and it's bringing up this memory from when I was in second grade. And that memory has held me back since second grade. I'm now 35 years old, and that fucking memory still impacts me. But now I'm choosing to tell a different story about it, or just not think about it, or I'm looking at it from a different perspective, okay? Revising it. But I wanted to come on here and use this as an example. And if this is a fucking memory that I have to keep with me and just kind of play with for the rest of my life, I will do that if it means that other people can understand what I'm talking about when I'm talking about revision. I'm okay with that because I know that part of revision is to stop thinking about it the old way. So the way I've been making videos, I don't even remember what videos I've made. So maybe this is the point where I can just completely let that memory go. We'll see. I am petting Jax because whenever I start filming, he's right here wanting attention. Anyway, so when I was in second grade, I don't even remember what the assignment was. We were gonna make dioramas. I don't remember if it was all ocean themed or animal themed, or I don't remember. I just remember that I made this really fucking amazing diorama about dolphins. And so my dad has been in printing his whole life. He makes all kinds of stuff with cardboard for a living. And so I needed a box. And, I was like, I need a shoe box. My dad's like, I'll make you a box. So he made me this like really nice box that I could make my dolphin diorama in. And I remember going to the library and like learning about dolphins and being like super excited about it. And I remember being like, ooh, it'd be really cool if I could like paint the inside, but do it with sponge paint so it looks like the ocean, and then take like clear string and like make the dolphins look like they're swimming in it, like all this really cool shit. I'm like, ooh, I could even get like a balloon because that feels like a dolphin, because I had gone to like SeaWorld or some shit at that point. I remember I had pet dolphins by then, so I knew what they feel like, and I'm like, ooh, they feel like a balloon, so I could put like a balloon in. I did this whole project, was so fucking excited about it, had so much fun making it, so much fun learning about it. Until I brought it to school. So my mom was a stay-at-home mom. She was at the school constantly helping, being a classroom mom, doing all the things. I don't remember if she was like just helping out that day or if she came for the presentation of my diorama. I don't remember. But I gave my presentation. I remember my mom being there. And afterward, the teacher came up to my mother and said to her in front of me, you know, you're supposed to let the kids do these projects. My mom was like, she did do the project. Like, I, you know, watched her and assisted a little bit, but like, this was all her. And the teacher just did not fucking believe her and was just like, well, next time she needs to do her own project. Ever since second grade, I have hated to learn, being forced to learn, especially. I talked about in the last video, I hated school. It wasn't until I got out of school that I realized I don't hate learning. I fucking hated it in school. Fucking hated it. Absolutely hated it. Didn't understand why, but it was because of that comment. I also was scared to create things. That also comes from at that same time, at that same school, we had a really horrible art teacher that everybody hated that gave me the same shit. I actually kept it because I love my little Simby. So when I was in elementary school, they made us sew stuffed animals. I was like in like fucking first grade. I don't know. This teacher was a fucking maniac. She was only there for 1 year because everybody hated her. But we had to make stuffed animals, and I wanted to make a parrot because my mom and dad had a parrot from before I was born. His name was Sinbad. He passed away years ago. Okay. And I made my little Simby. I'm like, this is Sinbad, my little parrot. And it was stupid and it was wrong and it was all the fucking things. Those teachers fucked me up really bad with their ignorant stupidity. And now, as a fucking adult, understanding that my thoughts, what happens up here, creates all of this, I'm deciding that shit like that is no longer no, that didn't fucking happen. Those fucking idiots never said that to me. If I think about it and I'm like, yeah, that just never happened. I don't know. That was a bad dream. I've been saying that. It's like, that was a bad dream. That wasn't real. Or I'm like, you know, my teacher actually praised me and was like, oh my God, that's genius. You did such a good job, or whatever. Just not allowing myself to relive it the way that I interpreted it as a child, that I was wrong, that I wasn't smart enough, that I wasn't good enough, that I whatever the fuck I however I all I interpreted it. I'm not gonna go digging for that. I've done that before and it doesn't, I don't fucking care. Because I know that the only way to like do anything about it is to think about it a different way. That's it. That's all you can do. I've done the therapy. I've done all the inner child healing. I've done the ancestral healing. I've done all the things. The only thing I never did was choose to constantly think about it a different way. So whenever I think about those things, not thinking about the parts that hurt me, that make me feel like shit about myself. Because to this day, I still think my little Simby's fucking badass. Hence why I still have him all these years later. Yeah, so I just wanted to come on here and share that. giving my experience with revision. That is what I've been kind of doing. And what I have noticed since then is the creativity and the willingness to try things and be open to things has shifted so much. I was blocking so much from myself because I allowed those people in my head, in my head. They don't get to be there anymore. I don't give a fuck that I actually had that experience. Not in here. Not anymore. My teachers always praised me. They always thought I was so gifted. I was so fucking smart. School was so easy. Were any of those things actually true? No, but that's what I'm gonna tell myself from now on, because I see how changing those thoughts in my head has changed my physical experience. I am working on a project right now that I will share with you at some point. But I absolutely love working on it. I was working on it over the weekend and I was just like, oh my God, the last time I enjoyed working on something as much as I'm enjoying this was when I made that project in second grade. I intend that this was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. Love and light.